Masters.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
Welcome all to another exciting edition of the Power Trading Hour. It doesn't matter whether you're in Montreal, Nepal, or even Senegal. We love it when you come to us at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
And we've been lower pretty much all the day on the S&P, somewhere between minus 4 or 5 to minus 20 points. Had a few kind of pushes. There just isn't any volume on the way up, not much volume on the way down after the first couple hours this morning. Dow's been up pretty much all day, up 210 right now. NASDAQ's been the weak sister, minus 142 as we speak. Russell's basically flat on the day. Crude's off just a little. Gold was down to under 1700 just before the market opened. It's come back a little bit, 1723. So, a small victory for the gold bulls out here, but we shall see. The real interesting part of today, as far as I can tell, is all about the TLT or the bonds. And do we have that up? Let's do this. It is below the previous low. It doesn't have the volume that it had before, but it hadn't looked like it's going to bounce at all. Every weekend, the Fed comes and throws a new wad of cash, which ends up going up into a giant ball of flames by the end of the week. Yesterday, we had another bond auction on Wednesday, and a little bit of action yesterday. But you know what? You just wake up and down another 2%. And you would say, okay, well, it's no big deal. It's down 2%. Just remember, that's 2% on a market that's 10 times bigger than the equity market. Bonds are at least 10, depends on who you listen to, 12 times bigger than that. So if you're down 2%, it's like being down 20% on the equity market for the same kind of dollars. Now, a lot of people don't look at it that way. A lot of people are not in the bond market, certainly don't trade them. You know, the big guys of the street tend to do that. But that is a massive amount of money, and everybody just kind of ignoring it at the moment. I think we've got at least some people believing that the huge bill passed this week, probably going to get signed in a couple of days, would add a little bit more cash to the market, maybe helping the fact that we are going to have much higher interest rates this year. So they may just look at it as a push. But that's fine in the very short term. But we get into the medium term, it's going to be a big problem, especially if, as I said, there's going to be a tale of two cities out here. And that's going to be the stocks that need cash and the ones that don't. If you need money from traditional means, i.e. you're going to the bank, it's going to be a problem. If you're Microsoft or Apple, it doesn't matter. You've got so much money coming in. It's worse than the mob. The money's just coming in fire hoses. You're looking for places to park the stuff. Now, if you are a growing company or you have a lot of infrastructure costs, let's say that you're in big industrial company and you have like 20% margins. You're not, you know, Intel or Apple at 65% average margins. That is a massive change to your profitability over time. Now, let's say that you don't want to do that. You're going to do the opposite thing, which is just as bad for the equity price, which is you're going to push out more shares in the stock. We've seen that in those 3D printer companies and them taking a more than a 50% haircut off the top of being pushed dramatically higher. I think SSYS was the first to do that. I don't know the other ones are. They just think they're going to do it. And the other thing is a real change kind of over the last week, and that is the last 15 minutes has always been for 6 months slightly higher. It's been rare to see market sell off more than one day, certainly not more than one day a week. Certainly not as many times as we've seen this week and last week see that last 15, 30 minutes sell off a bit. And, of course, today that you can't really go positive on the S&P 500 means that maybe you don't have a lot higher to go. Maybe the best argument you could make is it's not going that much lower. But at the same time, I'd make the argument that it's probably not going that much higher, that we found a position where a lot of people are ready to sell when they can, not when they have to. And no, I'm not in Kathmandu, although a good Bob Seger song, if I remember right. I got a question here. Can I do the rest of the show all about Meghan Markle? I think we're going to just do that. But first, we're going to get the rest of this stuff down, and then we're going to do nothing but Meghan Markle for the rest of the show. We'll be back with Tom O'Brien at 3:30, back with our Tech Insider segment. And I think that's all the thing we need to do now, except talk about a little bit of history.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
In something that probably shaped more of my life, mostly because my dad was a officer in the Air Force, Harry Truman starts what is going to be known as the Truman Doctrine, and that is to hold back the rapid spread of communism across the world, mostly pushed by Russia. Through 6,000 years of recorded history, whatever they've called it, Marxism, communism, socialism, it is shown to be an evil like no other. Everybody, it sounds real good in practice, but in actual practice, not so much. Anyway, in a dramatic speech to a joint session of Congress on this day in 1947, President Harry Truman asked for U.S. assistance for Greece and Turkey to forestall communist domination of the two nations. Historians have always called Truman's address the beginning of the Cold War. And now we're probably in Cold War 2.0 as we look at the expansionist policies of China. First in line after Hong Kong is now Taiwan. And, of course, 70% of the semiconductor business comes out of Taiwan. In one fell swoop, they could probably take us out as the leaders of capitalism in the world. We'll be back after this.
Are you grinding in the market but seeing little to no return? Or are you a successful trader simply looking to make his job a little easier? Learn to take the path of least resistance with David White's powerful trading newsletter. David White is an accomplished trader whose deep understanding of technology and the markets allows him to consistently find and share winning trades. Support and resistance define the ranges in which stocks trade. By understanding these trading ranges, David White is able to find the path of least resistance. David White's trading newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, is delivered daily before the markets open to make every trading day an easy win. Visit TFNN.com today and subscribe to David White's Ultimate Trading Newsletter for $119 a month and try all of our newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Take the path of least resistance at TFNN, educating investors.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we'll get to Meghan Markle in just a second. I know you're all just waiting for my opinion on that. Did have a question, though, on a stock, so we'll get to it first, and that is QBT, QUBT. Yeah, I said it. Just that seems to fly off the tongue. I think this is an over-the-counter stock, so of course I'm not that excited about it to begin with. But it is a stock. It is a company that makes algorithms for quantum computing. We'll be talking about that at 3:30 with Tom O'Brien or Tommy. I think it's Tom today. Anyway, we'll be doing that. But quantum computing is going to take new software and also new algorithms. A algorithm, to remind you here, are nothing more than a recipe, like baking a cake. The order of which you put different ingredients in, how long you incorporate those depends on the quality of the cake you get. Yeah, you probably don't want to put the eggs in after the last thing. You probably want to, you know, you got to put the oil and you got to, you know, whip the eggs and you got to put everything in an order. And that's why I don't do it. Algorithms are just a set of instructions that solve problems, but they, for classical computers like the one I'm sitting behind here today, they are radically different. We talked about Shor's algorithm before, which is one that works with quantums that basically can break any hash with about 10 guesses. Starts with a horrible guess. Doesn't matter how horrible it is. The guess gets better each time. And, of course, it means that anybody with access to one, let's say like a nation state, like China, could easily reverse the algorithms for, let's say, Bitcoin and empty your account instantly. So, you know, there's maybe some bigger issues abroad there. But you know what? I'm not thinking that owning gold coins is a bad idea right now. The reason I'm going to bring that up today with Tom O'Brien at 3:30 is there has been remember the Quantum Leap show? There's been a quantum leap in quantum computing. Over the last 4 to 6 weeks, a small company in Toronto has solved a great deal of the biggest problems. Of course, it's taken them 5 years to get there, but in the last 5 weeks, they've shown some techniques to get around some of the biggest problems. We'll talk about those biggest problems, how they solved them, and why I think we're on the road to actually more than a few of the other companies that are out there. Now, one of the reasons I'm going to bring this up now and have, besides foreshadowing my 3:30 spot on Tom O'Brien's show, is that this company makes software. Depending on what you're doing, these things are going to be pretty fast and pretty expensive. So, you know, is software going to be a key component? It kind of is. Of the people that make it to market first, you get the incumbent's position. That company already has at least two versions of software that can do different things on its systems. It is kind of a crapshoot. Anybody that's good with doing this is probably going to get bought out. Anybody that really understands any of it is worth a lot. So you have to worry about getting your employees poached by stronger companies. I believe this one's an over-the-counter one, so I'm not expecting this thing to get a lot of cash. Maybe they've come up with something great. I did some research in the last hour. I didn't see a lot in there. But I'm going to say that probably an overall view is if you can deliver a quantum computer with software that works in one company, it's kind of going to be like IBM, especially at the beginning. You want something that you can buy, that you can go to one company and get all the support. You know, are these things bad investments? Probably not a one of them, because eventually they're going to get bought out. The downside would be that they don't have any cash to speak of. I don't know on this one. I couldn't get any of the financials. But if as long as they have cash to continue, if you've got some smart people in there, the chances your company going to get bought out is pretty good. The chance that they're going to have long-term successful move in the market, probably small. So I'm not a big fan of these. The chart actually does look fairly good. And like I said, I don't know if any of these are going to do horribly if you've got a lot of PhDs in there that maybe some other big company wants to buy. But we've got lots of big companies involved. IBM basically has decided that its future is in quantum computing. I haven't looked at that one in a little while. But they, of course, are doing both hardware and software. Well, they blew up on earnings. They've come back exactly where you want to short them, and the volume was light yesterday, and it's even lighter today. I don't think they have anything ready to come out either. They said they were a few years. But again, as I said, most of these companies that have been involved in quantum computing have some big problems, and we're going to talk about that again at 3:30. But there's a lot of people that tried the original way of doing it, and I think they're going to find out that why they learned a lot, it was a lot of wasted time. So, I don't know if there's that much out there for somebody at the very beginning. But like I said, this is all black magic. And if you know anything about it, it's probably not going to be anything that's going to be a horribly bad investment. As long as they are actually a real company. But at that point, you have to start thinking, why would a company like that be over the counter at this point? Which to me is a big red flag. So we'll be back. Am I in Bitcoin? No, I'm not. Okay. And we've got some other questions as we go here. Let's see if we can get to mine. I know we've got a couple here. Okay, roadmap. Okay, got that. Dave, will you be at Fun and Sun? The answer is yes. I will be at Fun and Sun, which is now about 1 month away. If you don't know what that is, it's kind of like the biggest air show outside Oshkosh. which has about 200,000 people in planes show up. This one will be about 50,000, and it's just east of Tampa. But certainly if you have a vacation, one of the great things, if you're into aviation, a great thing to hit. So I will see you out there, Greg. What else is going to go on out here? We're looking at a few other things. Got just a little bit to go. Anyway, IBM, quantum computing. What else do we have? That's about it. What we're going to do for the rest of the show is go through the highly shorted stocks to see if anything's going on with them, as we got the bi-monthlies on Thursday night. Thursday and Thursday night. So we'll go through those. The amount of shorts in the market is certainly significantly lower. We'll talk about that as we come back.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we're back, and we're right ready to talk about Meghan Markle. But we have a phone call first, and that is going to be Ray from Northern Ohio, which sounds like Cleveland to me. How you doing, Ray?
Good. How are you?
Another day in paradise. You couldn't ask. It's going to be 80 degrees, not a cloud in the sky. Absolutely gorgeous here today. If anybody came down for vacation this weekend, they scored the lottery.
Yes, they did. Yeah, it's been a beautiful week here.
So what are you calling about?
Well, I got a AI program that I've been following. I get a 1 day, 5 day, 6 month, 1 year, 3 year signals, buys mm-hmm. and sells. And I just recently got a 6 month buy signal on AI. There's just not enough data on the chart for me to be confident in buying it, you know, it being a recent IPO. And I'm just wondering what your thoughts are on it, if you take a peek, please.
There's a lot of people involved in this, and probably one of the biggest tickets has been for the last 5 years is to come out with some kind of either quantum physics degree and with maybe something with AI. Most of the colleges that have done very well are northern ones.
Yes.
The one in the one I'm trying to think about. We used to hire a bunch of people from there in Toronto. Trying to think. Ooh, anyway, the gods of AI tend to be non-U.S. types. A lot of them in, especially a lot of them either in from Europe or from right outside Toronto. Man, that's going to be. It's going to bother me here for the next hour, mostly because they were willing to throw some money at AI in the early 2000s when no one wanted to have anything to do with it. Let's see if there's anything out here on it. Here's one of the issues with any of these companies trying to do it as software alone, and that is every PhD in the world is trying to become an instant millionaire by writing a paper about doing something incredibly nifty with AI. And of course, once you put it in a paper, how are you going to make any money off of it? Everybody's seen it. There's no patents on it. And if you did it for the school, it's probably public domain. So the real question is to dig in and find out what their business model is.
Mm-hmm.
Have you looked at anything from them on that?
Yes, and I look back on Tom Stiebel's history with, you know, Stiebel Systems and Adobe.
Yeah, but I mean, what's the business model?
Grids and you know,
I mean, they've got this kind of vague thing here that I'll read it now, which is company provides software as a service application for enterprises. This is software solutions includes C3, AI suite, platform as a service. Okay, here's the problem. Microsoft, Amazon Web Services, and all these guys are giving it away for free.
Yeah, and they're all competing with NVIDIA also.
Well, yeah, but NVIDIA on the hardware side, right?
Right, exactly.
This company's really just kind of putting it all together and selling it as a system. Mm-hmm. Stuff like fraud detection and all that. And
yes,
the problem
are.
Is that stuff is so ubiquitous that I haven't seen anybody really come up with anything that would change or move the goalposts for it. So whether you bought it from Microsoft or Amazon Web Services, it's hard for me to figure out what these guys are doing that Amazon and Microsoft wouldn't be doing for you already, or CRM, Salesforce.
Right.
But that's it. So are they going to be able to do something? My boss used to say, what you want to do when you're a small company against a bigger company is find the loose bricks, find out where they're not doing stuff. And that's not a bad business model to be in, because sometimes those very narrow things end up being very big. But there's not a lot here that tells you what these guys are doing that's much better than everybody else, or what narrow vertical market they're in that they do better than Amazon Web Services. And one of the reasons why is almost all this stuff is finely tuned for one specific purpose. That is that Google decided that they want to have something where they can tell all the different pictures and maybe see what face is in a picture if you're Facebook. And all these guys have spent billions on one very specific use of AI. And it doesn't really, a lot of these things really don't move well to other specific applications. And all you have to do to figure that out is try to make an AI program for finance. And you'll find out generally what the problems are. And these guys really are not trying to trade the market, as far as I can see from all their discussions. But, you know, is there business enough for everybody in the beginning? Almost always. But generally, the problem is at some point you have to scale out and it becomes so much cheaper at Microsoft's level or Amazon or Google's for doing the actual hosting of it. I'd need to go back and do a lot more research. I will look at this one over the weekend. I mean, they've got a lot of stuff, but Microsoft especially has been doing an incredibly good job of making these tailored spaces for anything that is not incredibly tiny, but, you know, not the big things that you would think, you know, the large solutions that are already out there. They are going after the medium ones. So that tends to make these kind of companies go after the ones that are a little less than medium and probably small. Doesn't mean they can't make money on it. And, you know, the weird thing is a lot of times you stumble into things that make huge money. But I don't, you know, I'm sitting here looking through some of this stuff. I don't see a great deal out here that says anything that they've done that. But again,
yeah, they've been trading for like 3 months now. And
yeah,
I think there's enough money in the market that they can, their stock can perform well. It's just, I think I'm right at this point, I'm a little too early to jump in.
Well, have they been out 6 months?
Not quite.
When's their lock?
Not quite. Let me take a look at their chart here. They've been around. Their IPO was. Well, I could pull up a 1 year chart and it'll tell me.
Was this a direct IPO or was it
December 9th of 2020?
Okay, so they haven't quite been out there. I'm not a big fan of jumping into these things until you see who's buying and who's selling.
Mm-hmm.
And the lockup is a real good indication of how many people want to stick in this.
Right.
So exactly. In this sector, I would be a skeptic and certainly would want to wait to see how many people sell the lockup.
All righty. Well, I appreciate your input.
Okay. We'll be back in a minute.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And we're back. We're going to go through some of these stocks as soon as we had a chance. Meghan Markle will have to wait. Analog devices, this one had a gap down, not a lot of volume so far. And it kind of looks like an ABC on the way down to me. We'll talk about it, but one of the biggest indicators and one of the reasons that a lot of semis are lower today is one of the biggest indicators for and the necessary products for processor designed electronics almost doubled its lead time over this week. So things aren't getting any better in the delivery part of the electronics market, and the shortages actually getting worse. You do have kind of a light volume down. This hasn't gotten back over the trading range. My guess is that you are going to at least retest the 142.25 level on analog devices, but highly shorted. So if it does get rolling in today, you may see some of these things start to move. Aon, we've talked about this one for a long time, kind of at its highs and massively shorted. If the market would break out and actually show some gusto here at the highs, I'd be watching that one as heavily shorted and almost everybody on the wrong side of it since they're so short the thing. ASO, this is Academy Sports and Outdoors. This thing's just kind of been going sideways for a while. It looks like distribution, but I don't see any real big edge there. Altus, you've got a couple of days. You've got a little volume out here today. I don't see any movement. AZN, which is AstraZeneca, actually above the trend line, kind of went and hit it almost exactly today. Biotech's not looking that bad overall. Had a nice day. Didn't follow through today, though. Basically just kind of going sideways. You were a little lower earlier today. Now, this one is right up against resistance on the trend line down. And, of course, you're right at it today. So Monday is going to be very important for all of the biotechs. But AstraZeneca, that one's pretty short. And actually, you got this high volume low back here at 46.48. If it could get back there on light volume and it retains a lot of that high short interest, that would be attractive. Colonial Capital, one of these stocks that probably you never heard of, slightly going higher on light volume but massively short, probably squeezing those folks out right now. Campbell Soup, one of the things I can't imagine being short, but for whatever reason, the men of the street hate this company, think that they're going to sit on it. Could this be another Robin Hood stock seems like the kind of one of the things they kind of like, one that's kind of benign, not a lot of news on it's going to change anything, and massively short that. I don't see any real, you know, you got a lot of volume the other day where you tested 4490 and closed back higher. But again, probably too many shorts in a soup company. Deutsche Bank, and of course, for years we heard about how this thing was going to go belly up. Never did. Government kept on throwing money at the thing. It's still up here, but one of the highest short interest stocks in the market these days. 8x8, which is a kind of a Zoom-like company. Any kind of real big close below this trend line now would be problematic on it, but massively shorted still. GERN, G-E-R-N, Garon, gapped down today, as a lot of volume, and probably going to retest the $1.63 low back here on March 4th. But at that low, if it dries up, maybe those shorts will decide to on delay. Okay. Apparently, we've got something going on. Let's go back here, get a couple of these windows closed so I can see what's happening. Now, trying to push it up higher. Still 2 points lower on the S&P cash. NASDAQ still down 110. Keep an eye on that. What else do we have? Oh, Halozyme Therapeutics. This one could be fairly interesting on a short squeeze base. It's already bounced, but it's up against resistance. If it could break through, it could get back up to about $48. HTA, this is Healthcare Trust of America. Up today, no volume though, problematic. To Infineon, up above, volume's not that exciting, but energy is good. That one may continue. Iron Mountain, as I said, I like this business. I don't know about how well it's doing financially. They store lots of data in old abandoned mines that are basically shielded from EMI, unless those pesky North Koreans decide to drop an EMI bomb on us and wipe out all our data. This looks like a very light volume move back up to 36.79. I still wouldn't short the thing. As I said, all these things have massive short selling in them already. Ironwood Pharmaceuticals. Looks like this could be doing an ABC on the way down. No volume on this. A little bit better yesterday. Didn't hold the high. A little push today. KDMN, which is Kademan Holdings. This one actually is testing the previous low of about 4.5 million shares with about a little less than half that. I would watch that one very carefully come Monday. MDRX. Allscripts broke the trend to the upside. Probably going to come back and pull back a bit, but not much bad there. MTG, Magic Investments. If your investment turns a profit with magic, you know it's a miracle. Okay. A little spike up here on no volume on this one, just above $13. So not a lot of short squeezes going on here today for the most hated among us. Nectar Therapeutics just went right up to the trend line and no juice the last 4 days going lower. Today looks like no other sign out here. OPKO, Opaco Health, up against its trend line, volume very light today. PEG, Pebblebrook Hotel, and a little bit of reversal signal at the highs. Again, we're going through the stocks that are most heavily shorted. I'm not seeing anything out here that really screams runaway short squeeze. But maybe Monday, if we go higher, we can get that. At the moment, just very, very light volume, especially in these stocks. We'll be back in a minute.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And as we get ready to close the show, Ronald asks about X1, which is a 3D printer company. This is one that we actually highlighted back in 2012 or 13 on the air with Tom O'Brien and the Tech Insider Hour. This company makes a 3D printer that makes molds out of sand. Basically, it does one layer at a time, sprays some kind of the equivalent of hairspray on it, and then prints and moves some more sand around. And if you're making, one-off models that you can cast, that is, just pour molten metal in a mold and kind of get fairly close to what you want, that's what these guys do, which is pretty good business. They kind of ran with the rest of the folks in the fact that this thing, these companies had been so heavily shorted, but kind of still on the trend line lower. Volume didn't increase as we got above it today. Could it go sideways for a while? It could. I think these things all need to consolidate for maybe 3 months to go sideways before they're ready to run or go again. As we close and go into the week, there is one thing that we should look at, and that is that TLT. It broke below. It looks to me like it will close below the previous low that they spiked on February 25th. Everybody got a little shocked on that one. Today, they're acting like interest rates going higher is no big deal. Now, in the short term, that may be true. In the long term, it will be true. At the moment, we've got a lot of these stocks that don't need any cash. But, you know, when we start digging in a little bit further throughout this year, interest rates being higher is a economy killer, along with a higher energy costs, some other stuff. Is it going to be everything? No. But I think the sectors will start to really change across the next, I don't know, 2-4 weeks. Sell when you can, not when you have to. We'll see you here Monday. And we'll be back at 3:30 with Tom O'Brien.